So let's start our lesson on white box testing by considering again program printSum. If you remember, this is the same program that we used when we were talking about black box testing. It's the program that takes two integers, A and B, and produces as a result the sum of the two. And when we were looking at this program in the context of black box testing, we didn't look at the implementation. But that's exactly what we're going to do now. So we're going to open the box and look at how the code is implemented. And as you can see, the programmer was kind of creative because instead of just adding the two numbers and printing them, he or she also decided to print them in a specific color depending on whether they were positive numbers or negative numbers. So positive results are printed in red and negative results are printed in blue. And as you can see, by looking at the code, we can see some interesting cases that we might want to test. For instance, you can see that there are two decisions made here. So we might decide that this is an interesting case, and therefore we want to test it. Similarly, we might look at this other case, and we might also decide that this is another interesting case, and therefore we want to test this one as well. So let's discuss this in a slightly more formal way by introducing the concept of coverage criteria, which are really the essence of white box testing. First of all, coverage criteria are defined in terms of test requirements, where test requirements are the elements, the entities in the code that we need to exercise, that we need to execute in order to satisfy the criteria. And we'll see plenty of examples of that. And normally, when I apply a coverage criterion, my result is a set of test specifications. And we already saw test specifications. Those are basically descriptions, specifications of how the tests should be in order to satisfy the requirements. And they also result in actual test cases, which are instantiations of the test specifications. And again, this is exactly analogous to what we saw when we were talking about black box testing. So let's see what this means by going back to our example. A minute ago, we looked at the printSum code and we identified two interesting cases for our code. And those are exactly our test requirements. So we have a first test requirement here, which is the execution of this particular statement, and a second requirement here. And this one corresponds to the execution of this other statement. So for this example, there are two things that we need to do in order to satisfy our coverage requirements: execute this statement and execute these statements.